From the podcaster, powered by Timbre Media.
Dr. Manohar KN has joined us from Manipal Hospitals. He's consultant physician and diabetologist, and he's been explaining various aspects of the new coronavirus to us. Now, this important one is on everybody's minds because already we are nervous, Dr. Manohar. How many more days to sit at home? How is business going to function? You know, the economy, what's going to happen? So is a cure somewhere in sight that's going to put an end to all of these question marks?
Desperate times call for desperate action.
Right.
Again, I would like to reiterate, new disease, we don't have a proven guidelines to the treatment. Like, for example, older disease, like including influenza or malaria, typhoid, we have proper guidelines on how to go about it.
Right.
So there are emerging guidelines.
Mm-hmm.
There are, again, I hope the people listening to it don't take this as they're on their own and start buying these medicines. That's one reason I usually avoid talking about it.
Right.
Because something is not proven and it will be counterproductive.
Right.
So people will start using these treatment options and then again neglect what has to be done.
Right.
So as of now, I'll keep it very brief in one line. First treatment is symptomatic treatment, rest, fluids, some citrulline, crocin, like that. Watch for any breathlessness and extreme fatigability. What are the emerging treatments? What should be prescribed only by doctors and not taken by the public is, there are some results like anti-malarial drugs,
right,
and few medications used to treat HIV are being considered to be useful.
Right.
So we need to wait for it, but we can't wait for too long. But the people who are involved in the management of this disease know better.
Right.
So this is just for the lay public to understand. There could be some treatment options, but please do not go and start buying these medications.
Right.
Unfortunately, in our country, anything can be bought
over the counter.
Right. So I request everyone just to abstain, but just to know that something could be done.
Right.
But you should not do a panic buying on it.
What about vaccines, doctor? Is there any clarity on when?
Vaccines, still far off. Because to get a drug or a vaccine to be in the market, it will take about minimum 12 to 18 months. And the WHO and even ICMR are fast tracking things for it. But still, I don't see it coming, definitely not before 6 months. By then, the worst of the disease would have gone.
Right, right.
So we may be able to prevent in future, because this virus could last for a few years, but not to this intensity.
Right. So in other ways, when you say this flattening of the curve, you just mentioned it in saying that it could be something that is gone from our lives in a short while. So is that what the flattening of the curve means? And how does that really work, to wrap up the conversation, Doc?
Flattening of the curve means, like, for example, one person transmits this disease from what you have seen in China and Italy to minimum of 2.5 people, minimum. So, and this virus multiplies in 5 days, 5 to 6 days.
Okay.
So, if we don't do anything about it, so 1% to 2.5, and in few days, it will be about 300, 400 from that one person.
Right.
But this 300, 400 will give it to lakhs of people.
True, yeah.
So, we have unfortunately seen a lot of minuses. Like the first patient who was diagnosed, the software engineer's wife,
right,
she got panicked, she took a flight, she took a train, and a bus, and then to meet her, get back to her parents.
Right.
In that process, it was counted roughly about 2,500 people were infected.
Right.
So then, imagine these 2,500 people, how many people they would have infected, and then the chain continues.
Right.
So that is when it happens, all cases come suddenly.
Right.
So as I said, incubation period. So let's say this lady has infected so many, in 2 to 3 weeks, you will have lakhs of cases in the country.
Right.
Because of one mistake.
Right.
So if everyone does the same, which unfortunately, as I said, someone is still protesting, someone is having a huge marriage, these are all irresponsible things, so that has to be avoided.
Right.
So if you stay at home, the spread from person to person reduces, peak will not come. Our families themselves can have better management facilities.
Right.
Doctors and the healthcare providers, hospitals can have better management facilities.
Mm-hmm.
That is why I said quarantining is important.
Right.
firstly, don't panic. Many times, it's not just a responsibility. Someone would have panicked. They said, oh, I want to go back to my house.
Right, yeah.
So then, without thinking what the implications could be, and they would have done this.
Mm. Yeah.
Sometimes, without knowledge also, it would have happened.
Correct.
So, quarantine is not a punishment.
Mm. Yeah.
Quarantine is a mechanism by which the medical fraternity has seen to minimize the infection,
mm-hmm.
not just to others, more importantly to your own near and dear ones. So please quarantine yourself. No need of panicking. There are a lot of helplines which are created.
Yeah.
So they can take, and there are doctors, and there are talks like this which you are conducting, which should be useful
absolutely.
To quell this anxiety.
Right. Well, we wish you the best, and thank you so much, doctor, to you and your teams who have been standing behind India in this fight against COVID-19. And thank you for, in your middle of your busy schedule, for joining us and helping us understand coronavirus and spreading right information with people.
Thank you so much. It was my pleasure. Hope we can contain this and we will win this war. But this can be won not by the government, not by the healthcare people. It is only by the citizens. Responsible behavior will win this. I hope we Indians can do it. We will do it. Please remember the old saying, an ounce of prevention is better than tons of treatment. Thank you. Jai Hind.
From the podcaster. Powered by Timbre Media.